Dear students, today we will discuss on topic mathematics in daily life, right? Now we will see the uses of mathematics in our everyday life, right? So here mathematics is all around us, it's everywhere we go. It's in our kitchen, in our house and in our surrounding. Mathematics is used in running shops, business, cooking and in every single activity we do in our everyday life. We will discuss in this chapter on topic cost price and selling price, profit and loss, unitary method and mapping skills. Here one example. Mr. Rishi, Raina's father, an electrical appliances shop owner, bought a new model of television set for ₹60,000 from a company. Since it was very new to the market, he was able to sell it to a customer for ₹80,000. The money Mr. Rishi paid to buy the television set is called cost price. And the money Mr. Rishi received by selling the television set is called the selling price, right? What do you think here? Did he get any extra money? Yes, he received ₹20,000 more than what he spent. So that is his gain because he is getting ₹20,000 extra. Now another example, Mr. Prabhu, Mary's father, who also owns an electrical good shops, tried to sell the same television set. But he was not as lucky to get a customer like Mr. Rishi. Finally, he sold it for ₹50,000. This amount is also called selling price. What do you think here now? Did he get any extra money? No, he didn't. In fact, he got ₹10,000 less than the cost price. So there is a loss of ₹10,000, right? Now we will discuss about profit and loss. Here 600 is selling price and 500 is cost price. So we can see here that the selling price is greater than cost price. So in that condition there is profit. And here we can see that cost price is ₹800 and selling price is ₹600, right? So here we can see that the cost price is greater than selling price. So there is, in that condition there is loss. Here we can say that the gain or loss is always calculated on the cost price, right? Here some formulas we need to learn this, okay? So gain is equal to selling price minus cost price. Loss is equal to cost price minus selling price. Selling price is equal to cost price plus profit. And selling price is equal to cost price minus loss. Here we are finding the selling price in the condition of profit and in the condition of loss. Now we will see the cost price in both the condition, right? So the cost price is equal to selling price minus gain and cost price is equal to selling price plus loss. Now we will solve a few questions of my practice time 1. So question number 1 is that find the profit. So A, cost price is equal to ₹659 and selling price is equal to ₹734.50, right? Here the given CP is equal to ₹659 and SP is equal to ₹734.50. So we can see that here SP is greater than CP. So there is a profit. So profit is equal to SP minus CP, right? So here we are subtracting 659 from 734, right? So here 0 minus 0 is equal to 0 and 5 minus 0 is equal to 5. So we cannot subtract 9 from 4. So we need to take borrow. After taking borrow, we are having 14. So 14 minus 9 is equal to 5. And after returning the borrow, there is 2. Okay. So now we cannot subtract 5 from 2. So we need to take borrow again here. So it is now 12. So 12 minus 5 is equal to 7. Now after returning the borrow, the 7 will be as 6. So 6 minus 6 will be 0. So there is a profit of rupees 75 and 50 paise. Thank you.